During your treatment at MD Anderson Cancer Center, your doctor may order a positron emission tomography, or PET scan. Radiologists use different types of radio tracers with your PET scan to measure important body functions such as glucose or amino acid metabolism. Radio tracers also enhance the images during your scan. The results of the scan help doctors diagnose and plan treatment for your disease. Check MyChart for your PET scan appointment time and location. You can also view instructions on how to prepare for your test. The instructions to prepare for your PET scan are different for each specific radio tracer used. You may receive one of these 9 radio tracers. Make sure to follow the instructions exactly as listed. Failure to follow the instructions may cause delays or cancellation of your PET scan appointment. If you are receiving the radio tracer F18 fluorodeoxyglucose, you must fast 6 hours before your appointment time. Do not eat or drink anything other than plain, unflavored, non-carbonated water unless otherwise instructed. You may take your prescribed medicines except for your diabetes medicines or anything that may contain sugar. Do not take your diabetes medicines or medicines that may contain sugar in a liquid or chewable form 6 hours before your test. Your last meal before the test needs to be high in protein. Avoid carbohydrates and foods containing sugar in your last meal. Eating food high in sugar will affect the results of the test. If you take insulin for diabetes, bring it with you to your appointment. If you have an insulin pump, keep it at the basal level with no bolus for 3 hours before the test. Do not exercise 24 hours before the exam. This affects how the radio tracer works and may affect the results of your test. If you are not on fluid restrictions, drink 32 ounces or 1 liter of plain, unflavored, non-carbonated water within 24 hours of your scan. If you are receiving the radio tracer F18 Fluciclovine, you must fast 4 hours before your appointment time. Do not eat or drink anything other than plain, unflavored, non-carbonated water unless otherwise instructed. No mints, gum, coffee, tea, soda, cough drops, or gummy vitamins. You may take your medicines as usual unless otherwise instructed. Do not exercise 24 hours before the exam. This affects how the radio tracer works and may affect the results of your test. If you are not on fluid restrictions, drink 32 ounces or 1 liter of plain, unflavored, non-carbonated water before your scan. If you are receiving one of the following radio tracers, F18 Piflufolastat, F18 Flotufolastat, GA68 Gozetotide, F18 Fluoroestradiol, CU64 Dotatate, or GA68 Dotatate. You must fast 3 hours before your appointment time. Do not eat or drink anything other than clear fluids, unless otherwise instructed. Clear fluids include water and ice chips, plain tea without milk or creamer, black coffee without milk or creamer, carbonated beverages, clear fruit-flavored beverages such as Gatorade or G2, clear liquid oral nutritional supplements such as Boost Breeze, Ensure Clear, or Premier Protein Clear. You may take your medicines as usual unless otherwise instructed. If you are not on fluid restrictions, drink 32 ounces or 1 liter of plain, unflavored, non-carbonated water before your scan. If you are receiving the radio tracer F18 sodium fluoride, you do not need to fast. You may take your medicines as usual unless otherwise instructed. If you are not on fluid restrictions, drink 32 ounces or 1 liter of plain, unflavored, non-carbonated water before your scan. You will need to take some precautions before your test. This applies to all radio tracers. Call the PET scan facility at the location where you are scheduled if you are diabetic, pregnant or breastfeeding, over 500 pounds in weight, taking a steroid medication, claustrophobic, unable to lie flat on your back for 15 to 45 minutes. If you have an on-body injector, pump, or a continuous glucose monitor, have a PEG or nasogastric feeding tube, recently received a high-density contrast procedure such as a barium swallow, must be transported by stretcher or ambulance. Failure to notify the PET scan team may result in a delay or cancellation of your appointment. Timing is critical for this test. Radio tracers have a short life. They are produced shortly before your arrival. They expire quickly and must be used within a short period of time. Therefore, it is important you arrive on time for your appointment. Make sure to call the PET scan facility and let a care team member know if you are going to be late or cannot make your appointment. If you have a history of problems with vascular access or are a hard stick, tell the imaging team when you check in for your appointment. Additional time and equipment may be needed to start your IV line. On the day of your test, do not bring valuables with you. Leave your jewelry at home and wear clothing that does not contain metal. Lockers are available to store your personal things. If you have diabetes, your blood sugar level will be checked if a current result is not available from an MD Anderson lab. Before the scan, your care team will start an IV line, and the technologist will inject a small amount of the radio tracer. It takes 60 to 90 minutes for your body to absorb the radio tracer. You may read, listen to music, or rest during the wait time unless otherwise instructed by your care team. Make sure to bring your own book and/or headphones. Right before the PET scan, you will need to empty your bladder. Having a full bladder may affect the quality of the images. During the scan, you will lie on your back on a padded table. The table will move into a large, tunnel-shaped scanner. It is important to stay as still as possible for the entire procedure. The scanner will take pictures at head level and move downward toward your toes, or vice versa. This part of the scan usually lasts between 10 and 40 minutes, depending on the type of test. From start to finish, you should plan to be in the PET department for 2 to 3 hours. For safety reasons, family members and caregivers are not allowed in the PET scan area. Children under the age of 18 and dependents must be accompanied in the waiting room by an adult other than the patient. Service animals are not allowed in areas where radioactive materials are administered or in the PET scan rooms. Make sure to have a family member or alternate handler with you to care for your animal when you are in these areas. After the test, a small amount of radioactive drug remains in your body for a short period of time. It is eliminated primarily through the kidneys and bladder. Drink 32 ounces or 1 liter of fluids after the test. You may eat and use the restroom as usual. A radiologist will read your scan and report the results to your doctor. Your care team will share the findings with you at your next appointment.